What do you do? Because it seems like then we almost need a third category, not with sheep and goats. There's only two of those, but in terms of faithful shepherd, false teacher, wolf. And it seems like there's got to be something in between, because what I'm getting at is there were some brothers, and I've already, shown my hand right there by using the term brothers, but I think there are some brothers that you and I would both be aware of, and with some pretty big platforms in the church today, who you look back on some of their teachings and you're like, man, that was really sound. That was some good gospel preaching. And I praise God for that, brother. There are just people who have come in droves to Christ because of their ministry, their preaching. And then there's been a drift as of late, it seems. And whether it's, like there's the age-old kind of prosperity gospel stuff that you've done a lot of work on, but there's some new things popping up their head. Critical race theory. I mean, the egalitarian thing keeps coming in, feminism, but that's it has some new tactics. It has some new tricks from time to time, but it's just the same old thing. But the race issue has been a big one. Critical race theory, and I praise God for guys like Tom Askell, Jared Longshore, Vody Bauckham, John MacArthur. Guys who have stood up against that. But there's some guys that like I really used to like their ministry. I like them, and man, they just hook, line, and sinker have gone woke, and just drinking the Kool-Aid, for lack of a better term. But I don't feel comfortable calling them a false teacher. You see what I'm saying? That's what I'm asking. Like with this third category, I think, because I think they're getting in to have, you know what I mean? They have a gospel message, but they're embracing this stuff that I really think that if they, I think they're trying to hold two things in tension that just are diametrically opposed to one another. And I think eventually, because I believe that they are brothers, eventually I think they're going to let this nasty stuff go and just hold on to that gospel and repent. And I'm praying and hoping and believing that, because you can't hold them both indefinitely, because they're both diametrically opposed. One's gonna beat out the other, and this woke gospel, it is another gospel, and it is in opposition to the true gospel. It replaces repentance with penance. There is now much condemnation in the woke church. There's no forgiveness. There's no the sin of racism is something that's the worst sin of all sins. And it's unbiblical, and it's not just unbiblical or extra biblical. It is contrary to the teaching of Scripture and contrary to the gospel of Jesus Christ. And you and I both know guys they've embraced this, and they're talking about their white privilege and why it's sin, and repenting of being a racist. And I'm like, well, if and saying there still are a racist. And I'm like, well, then if you still are a racist, then you should not still be an elder. If you really believe that, then go ahead and resign from ministry. You know what I mean? And so we've got that whole thing going on. But some of these guys, I just don't feel, and maybe it's me. So maybe you need to just call me to have some more courage. But I don't feel comfortable calling them false teachers, at least at this juncture. What do you think about that? Is that a 1 Corinthians 3 guy? Maybe.
Very well could be. Particularly if they don't right the ship, if they don't abandon it. Of course, as you said a minute ago, we would expect them to do that. It's been very disheartening that they have not done so already. But and I'm going to refrain from naming them because I don't, at least, no, I don't. I know. I'm sure you and I are thinking of probably a lot of the same guys. I can absolutely consider them to be brothers. But they have sadly and tragically been enchanted for whatever reason by the social justice stuff. And that is antithetical to the gospel on every conceivable level.
So, well, then let me ask this real quick. So we're saying, we start off the episode saying there is a biblical precedence, not just as permissible, but there is a mandate to name, publicly name false teachers. But you and I are both not naming some of these guys. And so I guess my question is, with the guys that Paul named, Demas, do you think that all the guys that Paul named, Hymenaeus, Alexander, Demas, these guys, do you think they were all, do you think they were all, were some of them the 1 Corinthians 3? Do you think Paul, the same Paul who wrote 1 Corinthians 3, and some of them will make it into heaven, but with their coattails on fire, they really are brothers, and they really are personally trusting in a true gospel. but somewhere in their ministry, they got off track and were building with wood and hay and stubble. And I think the guys that me and you are both thinking of would fit that bill. Do you think that some of the guys that Paul listed by name were that, or do you think that the principle is you only publicly name the full-blown bona fide Benny Hinn false teacher? Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. My guess is, in some of these that he named, we really don't know a lot of background information on them other than their names and what, Paul said. So there's not a whole lot of, deep exegesis we can do on, on exactly who these guys were and what the background story they had was. My guess is that some of them would have fit into the 1 Corinthians 3 paradigm, what Paul was speaking of. Some of them are not in heaven now. Some of them were goats that looked like sheep initially. Mm-hmm. They looked like sheep, but that's the rocky soil of Matthew 13, right? Initially they looked good, but then the sun comes out, trials of life scorched them away. Right. There's no root there. There's no fertile soil. Right. So, they look good for a while, but then they went out from us because they were not of us. So I think there's some of both.
Thanks for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, we hope that you'll take a moment and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can watch more content like this. Also, take a moment and give this video a like so that it can reach more people. And take a moment and click on the bell so that you'll be notified whenever we come out with new content. Thanks so much. God bless.